Let's start with our top story now. $8 billion. That's how much the federal receiver wants for California's inmate health care system. Clark Kelso said the monies are needed to build new medical units for thousands of sick inmates. Plus, he wants major legal consequences levied against the governor and the state controller if they refuse to hand over the money. KCRA3's Kevin Riggs is live in Sacramento with more on that. Kevin, what's this about?
Well, as you know, Adrian, Clark Kelso's motion filed today in San Francisco federal court worsens an already bad budget picture in California, the state already facing a $15 billion shortfall, and that has led to a budget stalemate here at the Capitol for the past 43 days. On top of this, the federal order that was filed today would require the siphoning off of $8 billion more, $3 billion of that this year alone. But Clark Kelso says that money is needed for health care improvements to meet constitutional standards, and he says his hand was forced by the legislature. In action.
We have fully explored and exhausted every avenue for securing this funding in a manner that least affects California's budget and immediate cash needs. But the state's leaders have failed to act. I cannot permit the state's fiscal and budget meltdown to interfere with my federal constitutional mandate to improve health care in California's prisons.
If the court indicates that we have a responsibility under the law, we certainly comply with the law.
Are you concerned about being found in contempt or possibly facing civil fines?
No. We've been following California law that requires an appropriation. Federal law could preempt, and so we're working with Clark, and we certainly want to talk to the judge as to what is proper in this context.
And again, the federal court could fine the controller and the governor in contempt of federal court and levy civil fines of up to $2 million a day if this order is not honored. Again, you heard the controller say that he believes that he's going to be working with the federal receiver and with the federal courts to try and avoid that. And the governor's office put out a similar statement today. But again, Clark Kelso has been working with the legislature for the past few months trying to come up with a bond package to finance health care improvements, the construction of 7 prison hospitals and improvements at 33 state prisons. And the Senate twice rejected the bond, and that's why Kelso says that his hand was forced and that he went to court today. There is going to be a federal court hearing in San Francisco on this matter on September 22nd, and all parties hope they can get the budget passed and get this issue resolved before then. Adrian, back to you.
All right, thank you so much, Kevin.